Hello, I'm Falagan. Today we are going to be wiping the floors with aliens. Hey, hi, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Xcom Logor Impossible. Today we are going to recover a crashed abductor because we need those fucking resources and we need them bad. We are going to be facing a rather significant opposition of 22 aliens including mutant berserkers, heavy floaters, sectoids, Mike Tyson and who knows what else. So we are coming down there. And this is our dream team for the mission. As you can see, we are coming in prepared psionically and tankishly with a lot of long-range support as well. And here's the details. First of all, we have Lanius Aurelius, who's going to be our close-range skirmisher in a tanky mech armor with kinetic strike module and a flamethrower, so that anything and everything up close gets fucked. He's bringing in tactical sensors for the dodge and core armoring for additional damage reduction. Next on, we are having Guillaume Letay with a particle in the zone squad side cannon with proximity mine launchers and grenade launchers to make all the alien lives feel rather miserable. And he's also taking armor piercing ammo and battle computer for dodge, aim and crit. Next on, we have our working psionic for this mission. As you see, these are the psi abilities. And he is bringing in a rather detailed set of equipment, which means he's gonna have to stay behind our lines, being rather squishy with only 10 hit points, because Aurora armor, while providing us with the aim bonus we need to make the boombox work, it doesn't really provide us with any defense, so we're gonna have to be stay way in the back. But David has medkits, of course. He has the boomboxes, three of those, with the 97 wield, they should work pretty well, and a mind shield for that 97 wield to be a of the fact. Next on, we have Suti, our crit sniper for this mission with Illuminati gun sight, alloy bipod and targeting module for aim and crit. Next on, Geraldine Romain with Walker Servo scope support medkit in case our medic gets one, and the plasma rifle. Her job's going to be the commanding officer and the fuck shit upper and the alien killer. Ta-da. Next on, we have Molting Bird coming in with a plasma storm gun for the mobility. We also have the recoilless rifle, factons and three of rockets and a flak ammo so that all the floaters that are going to be on the map feel like shit after a rocket hits them in the face and comes out taking their wallet with it. Next on, we have Bavarian Barbarian, who is bringing in a Titan armor, also known as the TT armor for the people who don't like three-syllable words. And he is our tank for this mission, so we have a reinforced armor, psi screen, impact vest and most likely the mind merge throughout the whole mission so that he can take a punch and then leave to talk about it. Because Bavarian Barbarian is our tough guy for this mission. And the last but not least, our support psionic with abilities as follows, Alloy Jesus. He's coming in with a TT armor, reflex rifle with a marksman scope for the in the zone on limited squad side range with a motion tracker and a mind shield so that we have 97 wheel mind phrase going in to fuck up the aliens. So yeah, that's that. Let's keep going and let's bring home that scrap metal so I can build myself a new bike because mine is still fucking broken. Have to take buses like a peasant. In any way, we are going to Africa. Sadly, strike not one. To India. Prepare I really wanted landing. To lower panic in there, but oh well.
Listen up. We're going to be dropping you deep in the Nigerian interior for the next operation.
Whoa.
The UFO came down in a sparsely populated area, away from any major population centers. We can secure the site with limited danger to the civilians in the area.
Okay, that's what we are going to do. Let's hope we are not going to start in some sort of shithole. But that's up to the Sky Ranger. Where will you drop us, mate? Please don't drop us in a shithole.
Come in, HQ. Big Sky has reached the outer marker. Approaching the crash site now. Strike team is awaiting your orders.
Affirmative, Big Sky. Strike one is free to engage hostile targets at the crash site.
That is actually a workable solution, I guess. So this is closed for some reason. Maybe it's just a force field. And yeah, that would be the best point of entry, to just enter through here and fight our way over there, rather than use the site. But we will see where the aliens are. Right in front of us, just where we want them. Okay, so let's get the Alloy Jesus in position over here. We are going to toss a battle scanner so that we can see our foes and friends alike. But let's make sure that we see our foes. However, before we toss the battle scanner, I'm going to set up everybody in position because it is not unlikely that me, the idiot as I am, are going to accidentally activate them, and then I may need the Alloy Jesus' firepower for this moment. Okay,
moving.
There we have a Suti.
I'm on the move.
Lanius can chill out over here. Pretty sure David is not going to be safe in there, goddammit. David, actually, you're gonna be good. Don't worry, mate, you're gonna be golden. Okay, now we have Guillaume as our support sniper over there. I want to be able to take them, you know, like a surf wave, just swoosh them out of position.
I'm on it, Commander.
So I need this is perfect. Okay, I'm going to overwatch everybody except the Rocketeer and the Sniper right now, and the next turn we are tossing the battle scanner to find our enemies, kill them dead, and then spit on their corpses. Maybe debug them just a little. Unless they walk into us, then I'm hoping that my overwatches will kill them. And I won't have to fight them. They are actually hitting those overwatches, I'm surprised. Good job, my soldiers. Oh yeah. Bring it on. You could actually even hit, that would be great. But you don't wanna, you don't have to. I'm fine with that. Okay, so first of all, let's start with David Rice's combat drugs, because we need those. But before we get a chance to use those, I really need to avoid getting Bavarian Barbarian in those combat drugs, so that I can use Mind Merge, because it's stupid as fuck that I can't toss Smoke Grenade and then Mind Merge, which I should be able to do with all honesty and everything, but I can't, and do you know why? Because the game's a bitch. So, even though I do have the option to Mind Merge and toss a Smoke Grenade at the same turn to cover the same people so that they get additional will and defense and everything else, I cannot. But you know what I can do? Since Alloy Jesus can't really see anybody, he's going to Mind Merge. There we go, now we have additional DR for our tank. And then David is going to smoke everybody. How do you like that, you fucking piece of floaters? I can't tell them that anything bad, because their name is just worse than anything I can think of. Who calls the enemies floaters, really?
Defensive position here.
Okay, so first of all, I'm going to destroy a little bit of the cover. Since I don't really need heavy floater corpses, I want to blow them up. Why? For the glory of Satan, of course, god damn it. I'm a general, for god's sakes. I didn't become XCOM commander not to use explosives at every possible opportunity, god damn it. Boom! I'm loving it. Now we are going to use our crit sniper to fuck him up. Because there is another pod right over there, and I don't really want to stumble into them. And you. Fuck you in particular.
Dead and gone.
And that's that. Now I can actually even hunker David Rice down, so he doesn't die like a little biatch. And overwatch everybody else, because there is one more heavy floater coming back. There it is. Oh shit, he's gonna throw a grenade at us, isn't it?
Come on.
Well, if we survive his attack, we are going to take it down. I should have used the boombox. Don't Okay. I say this is a very lovely day. And hello, lady. Before we go against that floater, however, I'm going to use the battle scanner, because if there are no enemies over there, if they patrol somewhere, then I can get out there and flank that little piece of shit. If I... It looks like I can, actually. Okay. Lanius. Hello, milady. And that means, of course, we are going to shoot this guy in the face, and if he survives, we are gonna punch him dead. Because that's what Lanius is for, that's what he signed up for, he even specifically stated that he wanted to punch it. Apparently, Lanius Aurelius is a proctologist. And, well, judging by whatever is left from that floater, he likes his job. In any case, now we can actually move a little bit forward. We have eliminated the first enemy, we have the battle scanner covering our arses. If anything bad happens, I'm going to call bullshit on this one. Why? Because I can. I don't have to be fair, I'm the commander. We are going to have Suti cover our descent, ascent, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. There we go. Overwatch. I'm considering sending somebody to pick up that med. Never mind. No, don't die.
X-rays coming in from the sides.
Okay, but that is not really an issue. I can just completely ignore this guy. We have a double tap right where we need it. Can I somehow sneak in that shredder rocket over there? Not really. But I don't have to. What I have to do, however, is double tap that guy. We have a 36% chance to crit. Why not? Let's pew pew. Hello, is it me you're looking for? Also, hello, my name is Suti. I live on the second floor. Oh, that one was better. See, now we know Suti's musical tastes. Okay, we need to get the GM to also open fire. I do not think we will be in range if we go over there. We are, but not to whom we want. Fine, sectoid is also a good prey. Oh no. However, in all seriousness, what are we going to do is, we are going to set the Bavarian to tank that guy down. I'm going to send Alloy Jesus to actually pick up that meld. Why? Because I can. I can and I will. Lanius is gonna chill over there and just reload. He's gonna need the ammo. Who is that? That's not the person I want on the front line. That's a person I want on the front line. We are going to, of course, utilize smoke to cover everybody, because we can. And there is no real reason not to. And I'm going to try to see if I can actually do it like this, or is just... Okay, theoretically now, even though Bavarian is in the smoke, he wasn't in the AoE circle, so I'm going to see if I can fool the game a little bit. You are fooling with me, I'm a fool with you. There you go, see? You are now under effect of both the combat drugs and mind merge. Why? Because he was not in the AoE circle. Let me just see. Mind merged. Damn it, you're not under effect of smoke officially. Just graphically. Well, the game didn't let me cheat.
Headed there now.
Okay, why you not let me cheat against your stupid rules? Why you have stupid rules, game? What's up with you?
Hmm? Resupply completed.
Okay, and now let's send Alloy Jesus to pick up that meld. He has to get out of the flank anyway.
Taking fire over here.
Oh no. We got shot by a mectoid, who's now going to come and he will shoot Bavarian, because there is nobody else to be shot.
Okay, je surveille la zone.
Well, there is, of course, Lanius and Guillaume, however, they are not in a position to be an easy prey. So, Bavarian is the only good target. There you go, perfection. Now we got a sectoid trying to be a little kebab. And it's shielding from there. That's lovely. Don't you just love it when the aliens do that? When they could easily shield from the behind enemy lines. And, you know, just completely fuck up any plans and hopes you might have for survival or anything else. But instead they decide to do it in a way that just requires the absolute minimal effort to take care of. You little cheeky fucker. Did you see that cheeky fucker? Oh, you cheeky fucker. I was going to. I really was just going to use the Indezaur on this guy. But he just made me do it. See? Look what you made me do! Look what you made me do! Piece of shit sectoid. Okay, now we are going to use the motion tracker in our endeavor to pick up the meld. Because we don't want to activate any additional pods, right? So, let's keep it safe. We should be safe if we get over here.
Heading out.
And if the meld is still gonna be there next turn, it's ours. Now, as for Suti, I'm going to see, is anybody else in range for that mectoid? Not really. Well then, Suti kills a mectoid. Or not even. That is okay. It's a-okay, because we have, of course, Bavarian. Bavarian doesn't give a fuck. You are too far away to shoot, you're just gonna come closer. Oh no, the sectoid shot Bavarian Barbarian for 1 damage. And we have another mectoid core to sell. Boom. Position now, of course, that doesn't mean we are safe, so we are going to dedicate a little bit of my firepower to take care of this guy. However, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna push Lanius over here. And then I'm going to try to command Lanius so that he can use the flamethrower.
Hostile unit.
Oh, you did not just. You just made that shit up on the spot, game. That's just fucking bullshit and you know it.
On my way.
Well, yeah, we can't. You know what I'm gonna try to do instead? I'm going to try to lure the berserkers over here. I never tried to use the boombox on berserkers, so let's give it a shot and see if it works. Now we can of course shred them. We can of course just use a rocket on them. Which actually doesn't make any difference right now. I might as well. What's the worst that could happen?
Suck on this.
We kill the sectoids, so the berserkers come a little closer. Which doesn't matter in the least. They will anyway. Whatever we do. Now, whom can we command? We can command GM. Might be good if GM gets the fuck out of here. But you know what might be better? If we put a proximity mine and do it in a way that's actually going to hurt the berserker who steps on it. But not our own mech. Yes, that's what I want. I don't know why, and I don't think it's gonna do all that much, but you know, maybe if the boombox worked, they would walk into the mine as well.
Hostile targets moving to withdraw.
If not, Lanius is going to take a lot of
I'm all right.
beating. And the fucking alarm clock, I keep forgetting it every single day. I forget the alarm clock. Weapons free. Oh, now you're just being... Yeah, now the game is just being annoying, isn't she? And, suddenly Longor became a she.
It's gonna take more than that.
Yeah, it might take more than that, Sectoid. It's a good try, though. I'm gonna give you 1 point for the effort. Now, let's pick up that fucking melt before everything goes to hell.
Aye, aye. Got the goods.
Yay. Now get the fuck back. We have exactly 2 shots with Suti. We have the Shredder Rocket. We have the Rapid Fire. We have everything we need. You know what we do not have? We do not have chances of survival for Lanius Aurelius unless we actually just retreat right now and get ourselves fixed. And hide, first of all. But before we start shooting rockets and anything, there is one thing we gotta do. It's called coming a little closer and putting a proximity mine where I actually need it. It's going to cause the one that I don't need to explode as well, but what can you do? We have 3 berserkers that require a shredding.
Placing proximity mine.
Okay, now we will shredder rocket those guys. Now when they move forward, they are going to receive the damage from Shredder Rocket, and then the proximity mine, and if I'm lucky, then the other proximity mine as well.
Boom.
Boombox, of course, didn't do shit.
Eat shrapnel.
Yeah, eat shrapnel, whatever, boom. Okay, we actually almost killed one. Oh, shut the fuck up. Oh, they are coming at me even more. That I didn't see coming. Nor do I give a fuck. That was awesome. Now you, my dear friend, must die, because there is nothing else I can do with you. And let's fuck up Berserker. Boom!
No longer a threat. I could use some ammo over here.
And we have a double tap. I'm going to use to... Now that's a good question. I may... Yeah, I have to shoot that Berserker, so whatever. Boom, 16. Sweet, sweet 16.
Out rounds.
Now get into my range. Thank you. Boom!
Alienator.
Now what we need right now is very simple. We need to be able to mind merge with Bavarian, because Bavarian's gonna be taking some shots in the face. Do we need anything else? Do I need that smoke grenade? I don't need that smoke grenade. Though actually, yes I do, because Guillem is rather fragile, so I'm going to smoke up Guillem and mind merge with Bavarian so that they shoot Bavarian and don't do anything to me. That is the plan. Who's that? Bavarian? Bavarian? How you like the other mind in your head? And... let's protect ourselves from the enemy. I'm going to, of course, have to fix Lanius with medkits, but I can't do it right now, because mind merge was simply more important. Now, mutants actually ate that boombox. Wow. I didn't expect that to happen, but they did. They did eat the boombox. Very well. Who am I to say no to, you know, kills that are being given to me? I will not shoot those guys, but I will try to sneak in one against that muton. Oh well.
Shot failed to connect.
We can't utilize Lanius. But there is nothing really stopping us from using in the zone and then hunkering Some more. And that's actually very good because we need bloated corpses. Now we are one for rolling once more. And they're reloading. Because fuck you, aliens. Of course, that means that Alloy Jesus actually has time to return. He goes through the fire because he's that badass. He also is known that he never looked at explosion, even once in his life. Okay, now.
Heading to that location.
We are self-repairing, of course, but I'm still going to use medkit. Why? Because
don't
we have
move.
Five
You'll
of them,
fine.
So we can speed up Lanius' return to battlefield. Again, I'm not that proud from the fact that he got beat up like this, but there was nothing I could do with the completely unexpected activation, just one tile too far. That's the story of XCOM, one tile too far. There is always the alien pod, one tile too far, one. Not two, not three, not five. One is the number of tiles that the aliens are too far behind. And we can't get that mutant out of there. You know, this guy actually chose a very good hideout for himself. He's a smart mutant. Hey, you know who that is? I know who that is. That's Isaac Newton, the famous alien physicist. That's the guy. And was that joke cheesy or what? No! Mutant takes a reaction shot. And misses. Why? Because mutants are dipshits. Except for Isaac. Isaac is awesome. Can I have your autograph on the bullet, Mr. Isaac? Thank you. And, well, now my sniper still doesn't have a shot. But that's okay, because now I can move on with my life. It is now complete. And one more medkit and Lanius can actually get back into the fray. Damn it.
Location confirmed.
Let's move to where we need ourselves most.
Roger that.
Moving to Overwatch.
Lanius can't get out there yet. Well, he could, but that would be a little risky, and I've already risked his life enough for one day, I think.
Time to motor.
Okay, now let's see what happens. They can't really do anything. I didn't mind merge with Bavarian, but that's because I simply had to dash. And medkit. I said dash and medkit because I have two mind merges. Oh, Isaac is dead. All the mutants are going to go to his funeral. Poor Sir Isaac. Oh, sectoid, please. I think that's one of the moments where you just have to say, bitch, please, isn't it? He was trying so hard. In any case, GM, you are our most fragile mech, go first. Nothing. Okay, I'm going to keep your last grenade.
Je suis de retour.
And the last third medkit goes out there to make Lanius whole again. And all the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't get Lanius together again, but three medkits did it. Okay, I'm going to keep Overwatch as in here because it seems to me that that mutant is trying something.
Cover position here, watching.
And if it is not, well then he better fucking shoot.
On your order.
He should. Okay, now if he tries to get out of there again, then of course Lanius' close combat specialist is going to do the trick, and nobody can shoot Lanius without actually putting himself in harm's way.
Got it.
And you may not know that, but the harm is a licensed killer. Okay, we got the blood call. Hey, chief, blood called. What the fuck did it want now? It says the mutants are coming. Oh, so that's why we have a sectoid over here. That's the one. That's the top northernmost. We have a mutant blood calling over here. We have a something, some runaway thing, probably a floater over there. And check this, I think the command pod over here. No, because it patrolled over there, there is no way unless it's here. Well, we'll see. In any case, I think we can actually... we know that the mutant blood calls are not on our Overwatch. Let's go there and kill him. Oh, we can't? Where did it hide? Well, she knows. Let's go back. I will, of course, kill that guy, but I have better killers on hand, so there is no point in putting Lanius at risk. Because a 36% shot is not the same as a 98 flank. Boom! I think that sector died of a heart attack before the shot even landed.
I have you covered. Reloaded.
Alright, now we have all the close combat specialism we are going to need. Which is, I guess, fine. David's gonna not stay in the back because there may be an enemy patrol coming at him, so that would be... That would be pretty sad if that would be the end of David.
Double time.
Okay. So theoretically, we should have shit covered right now. At least to a very big extent. Let's put our sniper in a position to be safe-ish from the enemy patrols that are coming behind me right now. The door just opened. I saw it, see? Told ya. Okay.
Moving out.
I will have Lanius get out there and fuck him up.
Got something over here.
Hello, command pod. That's actually pretty bad. We can burn them. Okay. And then we would have to dash. And Lanius would have to take the blank of the explosion. So why don't we instead hide and make it so that they would have to take the bulk of my explosion. Will I do. Can explode too. So that would require a very risky maneuver. We could either dash down the molting bird over there, set up Lanius to prevent them from opening the door, and then Lanius would protect Molting Bird with the help of our flanking unit over here. We would get Guillaume next turn, he would hide. You must get out this side so you can shoot inside. Alloy Jesus likewise. Geraldine would get over here and fire. Or maybe we would just set up a Varian. Where is Aloysius? Over here. So Aloysius would have to get over here. We would set up a Bavarian to take the force of the explosion. Should be in the visible range from you, so mind merge. There we go. Now they have somebody to shoot at. Okay, sniper has to get in this position so we can shoot inside. Come on, Sooty.
Moving out.
Times are wasting. Can you actually shoot somebody? Maybe. I might want to have a grenade inside to break the piece of cover that they are using, but that's not gonna do all that much to me. So since I'm not going to be using GM this turn, I might as well check. Is Jetboot module costing me an action? It does not. See, that's a good thing to check.
Defensive position here.
Now I will know for the future and can use it accordingly. Okay, you on the other hand, you have a job. You have the flamethrower over here. Pom, 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 pom. But then we would be getting Molting Bird over here. That's not gonna stop the outsiders from getting us, however. I'm sorry for taking so much time, I'm just thinking. It's not an easy situation with the wall in here blocking my way, actually. Let's see if we can make the situation easier. If we can break that piece of wall, then we should be goldenish. Can we break that piece of wall? Can we break it? Yeah, shake it till you make it.
Moving out.
That makes my life much easier because now I can just, you know, get here and open fire. What's that? That's a muton. So I can't theoretically kill that muton. Let's make sure that this happens. Greedy. Oh, we killed it anyway. Okay, I'm fine with that. So now we can try to burn those guys. Even if the outsider won't panic, and I don't think it will, we also damage the sector commander. And most importantly, no, the floor didn't catch on fire. Fuck you, floor. Don't you just hate floors that don't catch on fire? I have those in my house and I hate them. There we go, that's just a feedy, that's not good enough. Of course, the most important thing right now is going to be the boombox that is going to maybe do something good for us against that muton and probably do absolutely nothing to outsider and commander. But I'm taking anything I can get right now. Now, Molting Bird will hunker down. And you will overwatch. Okay.
Notify engineering of possible repairs.
That was to be predicted. Lanius is
incoming
going to be
fire.
A while in the infirmary after that. But next turn he's gonna jump down and fuck him up, so that's good.
Hostile fire at my position.
Oh yeah, hasta la vista. You can hostile fire my ass. Because Lanius is indestructible. Speaking of being indestructible, let's put you, my dear friend, down there. Hello, hit the Overwatch, I know you can do it, it's just an outsider fire, it's gonna cost you 5. Or nothing. Aha! And we get a what? We get a boom. We get a box. I'm going to damage them all a little bit. And then Lanius is getting down there. Because Lanius is a non-give-a-fuckus.
Affirmative, Commander.
He's going to shoot one and then he's gonna burn them all. He's gonna shoot this one to be specific. And then the flamethrower, while not going to kill them, is gonna be amazing and awesome and fun for the whole family.
Preparing flamethrower.
Don't you just love to do it? And the Bavarian also got caught in the blast, but guess what? Bavarian gives no fucks. Okay, let's kill you.
I'm running low on ammo.
And your friend. Because I don't want them regenerating, you know? Now we get the GM, who may not look like it, but is just literally burning to kill them. But before we use the in the zone to get rid of all the enemies using GM, we are going to use a normal rocket to make sure that the in the zone can hit everybody by destroying this guy's half cover. And now we can just in the zone all three of them, like little bitches. They are, because they're mutants. You are going to be last, you go first. Your mutant friend is going second, and the outsider, I mean, sector commander, goes
X-ray
down there.
Neutralized.
Oh. And the last but not least, captain goes down with his ship.
A Another one down.
Another one bites the dust. And another one, and another one, another one bites the dust. Woo! And another one bites the dust. Okay, so yeah, we got some resources from that. Elanius is going to probably be in the infirmary for a while due to that little fuck up with berserkers. I should have known better than just rushing, but I wanted that flamethrower. Now I'm gonna have to live with my mistakes. And that's gonna be 18 days in the infirmary. Oh no! Well, Elanius, enjoy your leave of absence. Now, we got Guillaume. I have a choice. Either I take lock and load, so I can just reload and shoot at the same time within the zone, which is fucking awesome. Or go for vital point targeting to increase the damage. I think vital point targeting in this particular case is going to be better, because we definitely carry enough ammo on our main cannon to pretty much clean up everything there is with GM, so there is no need for any... Okay, simply, there is not enough aliens to kill for the lock and load to be needed. And vital point targeting is going to mean that we will do additional damage against everything, because we have all the autopsies and shit. So yeah, plus 2 damage in this case within the zone is gonna be great. Because we may not be able to kill as many enemies per turn, because maximum of 5 or 4, but we will do additional 2 damage, which means we can kill more of them in effect. Now, we got some Elerium, some alloys, stasis tanks, surgeries and all the broken shit. I'm gonna sell all the broken shit and repair all my broken shit. I don't require anything right now. I'm gonna have to start working on Archangel armors soon, but I'm gonna do it after the base assaults, which we are going to be making. Actually, speaking of which, how about we start working on those skeleton keys, because I only have one. Let's manufacture so many that we have 3. That should keep me covered if we lose countries in May, so we can base assault and retake them fast. Because for satellites we only need money. And we have a small scout coming to scout the target. I'm going to send a laser cannon. Because... why not? I'm waiting for the overseer to show up in Asia, where I have 2 firestorms ready to try and take them down.
Engaging bogey.
Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Don't be a bitch. Abort! Jesus fucking Christ. I'm not even Christian. We really need something better than the laser cannons. Fuck, Phoenix cannons are better than laser cannons for us right now. But that doesn't matter, because soon I'm going to go for the EMP for my fighters. You run away, you stupid scout. Anyway. I can't start an active research right now, but... I'm waiting for the Elerium and weapon fragments to start the EMP weapons, which are going to make sure that we remain superior in the air. Do we want to do the same thing again? Why the fuck not? Send the laser cannon, but this time on defensive. We have time to engage them long enough. I have like a million of the boosters stacked.
We're in pursuit.
Not gonna use any other consumables for this one, because we need it for overseers. You're shitting me, right? Come on. There you go, that's the way you do it. And we get ourselves a training mission, because we have mutant elites, berserkers and mutants and outsiders, so that's something that our lower level troopers can handle. So that's gonna be our next mission. For now, thanks for watching, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If so, let me know in the comment, like the video, follow me on Facebook and Twitter and so on and so forth, and I will see you again in the next episode. For now, thanks for watching and bye bye!